Brother teacher here, are you living a life of presumption? Do you assume that you'll be here tomorrow, the next day, next week, next month, even next year? Do you have that presumptuous mentality, just thinking, you know, I know for sure that I'll be able to go to work tomorrow or next week and make that paycheck and bring it home to the family and take care of my obligations and my family? Do you think that way? Then you really need to stop thinking that way and rethink your ways, because we don't know what tomorrow will bring. Case in point, watch the news. You'll see that someone is dying every few seconds in the world somewhere that perhaps assumed that they were going to be living the next moment, the next hour, the next day, the next week or so. So don't take life for granted, ladies and gentlemen. That is the point that I'm trying to make to you. So by saying that, I want to say this. Get your house in order today. Do the things that are necessary to help your family down the road or in the future, be it near future or even the distant future. Do it today. If you, who are the heads of household, parents, fathers, mothers, whoever the caregivers are of your children, if you have children, you would be doing yourself a great disservice if you did not have life insurance in case something happened to you. God forbid that it does, but if something happened to you, you should have life insurance so that you can take the burden off of your family trying to put you away when you're gone. Funeral costs can be well up into the thousands of dollars, as much as $10,000 for the average people. But nowadays, a lot of funeral directors, they have packages as low as $500 to $1,000, especially if you're being cremated. But if by chance you don't want to go that way and you would like to see your loved one for the last time and allow the friends and relatives to still see the remains of that person in their physical shell, traditional wake and funeral, then you might want to start putting money away for that cause. And you might want to invest in the future and get you some life insurance, fathers and mothers, okay? You might even want to get life insurance for your children. It's always interesting to me how people can spend money on all of the things that they enjoy, sports, memorabilia, sports events even, going out to the movie theaters and going out to dinner and lunch and to the bars and hanging out with the friends and, you know, having parties and all of these sorts of things. And when sweetest day comes around and birthday parties come around and Christmas holidays and Thanksgiving, we always have a extra desire to, you know, to enjoy life and to just splurge. But when it comes down to the matters that really matter, we can never find the time and we can never find the money to finance the things that are the most important things in our lives. Just in case. That's an old expression. Just in case something happens. Do you have money put away just in case something happens? Do you have life insurance just in case something happens to you? Do you have life insurance for your children just in case something happens to them? Now, we would always hope that nothing would happen, especially in the early stages of our lives. But just in case, are you prepared? Do you have smoke detectors in your homes just in case there's a fire? Do you have a small kitchen fire extinguisher or a couple fire extinguishers in your home just in case there's a fire that maybe you can put out? Do you have some extra money for a rainy day just in case your job lays you off? What if your car broke down and you don't have sufficient money to pay for it? and I would hope that you would have car insurance, at least liability, to protect the other individual, just in case. Are you taking care of your health on a regular basis and conscious of it as you do it, just in case your health were to fail from lack of exercising, lack of proper nutrition, just in case? Are you encouraging your family to save money? Your children, your nephews, your nieces, even your parents, if they don't have that habit. All it takes, really, ladies and gentlemen, is just doing it. Do you have too many extra things that you're spending your money on that you don't necessarily need? Cable television. Do you have to have it in four rooms in your house, just in case you needed the extra money? Do you have to have 30, 40, 50 pairs of shoes, ladies, just in case something happens? Do you have a side hustle or a side job? Again, if you were to be laid off from your own regular full-time job, is there a skill set that you have that you can rely upon to bring you extra income just in case that were to happen as well? Just in case. Think on these things, my friends. Just in case something were to happen. I will see you hopefully in the next video. Please leave your comments and your viewpoints in the comment section below. And always keep my videos somewhere close to your heart that you can always reflect back on them, just in case I'm not here. This is Brother Teacher. So long.